MCAS Banco de Panama. I hope that is how you say that word. Panama City, Panama. MCAS Banco de Panama has been implicated in Lacerda's arms smuggling operations and has been facilitating deals with Lacerda and his allies. It must be determined who paid MCAS Bank to organize Lacerda's payment for the Morgenholt kidnapping. Greetings, fellow links. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. To catch up with whatever has happened thus far, Bruce Morgenholt, a scientist working on the Masse Kernels, had been kidnapped and tortured for information. He could not be saved, but the information learned from him has been destroyed. And just to tie up loose ends, the guy who was essentially contracted to kidnap him and torture him has also been eliminated, hopefully sealing everything. But we still don't know who actually hired that guy and who's trying to gain information about the Masse Kernels and to what effect. So all we could learn from the guy who was contracted, the mercenary essentially, was that these guys, the MCAS Banco de Panama, is what essentially was somehow connected to that guy. These were the guys that were fund rolling his operations. So we head here to figure out what happens next. And, well, to be honest, this is honestly one of the smoothest levels in the entirety of Chaos Theory. And a lot of people even consider this level to be the finest in all of Chaos Theory, if not just the entirety of the Splinter Cell franchise. And this game in itself is considered to be, well, the epitome of stealth gaming. So, might not be wrong to call this level the best in stealth gaming, to be honest. But anyway, everybody is entitled to their own opinion. And yeah, without digressing any further, let's go ahead with this.
With still no word from the North Korean government, China's Long Dan again urged all sides to come to the bargain. We have now a late response by Admiral Toshiro Otomo of the Japanese ISDF.
Despite the ambassador's efforts, nothing has changed. The Japanese people must continue to endure harassment and humiliation. We eagerly anticipate the arrival of the...
Hey, I hear you leaving us. Heading back for Panama?
Hate to eat and run, sir. We have a few loose ends to tie off before we can rejoin you.
Well, if you can make it back for the 4th of July, I'll show you one heck of a good time, boy.
Wouldn't miss it for the world.
Fisher, the arms that Lacerda had were purchased by someone using a Panamanian offshore bank as proxy. I want to take a peek inside their records. Unfortunately, it's not as simple as that. This op can't look like a U.S. intelligence gig. So to cover it up, you'll need to crack the bank's vault and lift some bearer bonds. Property of the French government.
I hit the bank's servers last night, but I didn't find much. All their workstations run drivers for plug-and-play hard drives. I'm guessing they secure them physically every night. Crazy world we live in where electronic intrusion is more of a threat than physical intrusion. Anyway, they probably store the drives in the main vault, meaning they're not going to be easy to get a hold of.
First, the good news. You've been in this bank before. You were part of a CIA raiding team that went in 89 looking for some of Noriega's drug money. Most of the intelligence we have on the bank actually comes from your team. The bad news is that we have a lot of physical security. Lasers, motion sensors, locked doors, cameras, the whole lot. And none of it was there in 89. We've also contacted a specialist to help crack the vault. You better talk to him.
Look, I don't know who you are or why I'm helping you, other than it's better than staring at the ceiling of my cell. Oh yeah, you have to face some Mason Wells 88. Well, it ain't a one-man job, but they tell me you can do the work of five men. Fine, I says. I had your mate Willie make a little deposit for you. You'll be needing some things from a safety deposit box in the little vault that we can use to crack the main one.
We'll continue on our course for the Yellow Sea and send you back by helicopter to Panama City. I have no authorization to act inside Panamanian borders, so you'll be operating covertly out of the embassy. You and your partner will be on your own in Panama.
Just something that I wanted to make a note of here. Isn't a CIA raiding team considered to be special forces? So, on top of being a Navy SEAL, Sam is also a part of the special forces. Now that is a different level of badass. Excuse me for a minute there. Alright, and we are going to be taking our stealth loadout as is usual. Again, we do not want to discharge a single shot apart from whatever comes out of a pistol. So none of these actually matter in this level. The only time that your ammunition actually matters is in Seoul and then in Bathhouse, and that's it. So if you're doing like a pure stealth run through, you can just disregard all of this, like at your own leisure.
Hey, Emilio, ¿has visto los sensores de movimiento nuevos?
No, ¿qué hacen?
Cuando detectan movimiento, se enciende la luz.
Vaya, qué lindo.
Parece magia.
Voy a poner uno de esos en mi aparcamiento. Imagínate, bar de noche, te montas en el coche y la luz de la entrada se enciende sola.
Estás tú bueno. Es alta tecnología, Emilio. Costará miles de dólares.
Supongo que tienes razón.
So we need to be a little careful here because there are lights all along this garden which are motion sensitive. And the first thing that we're going to do here is trip the breakers so that things become easier for us. Which is our ally.
Fisher, I just synced your offset with intelligence on the bank that you and your team gathered back in 89.
Ah, the memories.
Yeah. Judging from your report, sounds like it was quite a vacation.
It was, actually. I spent most of the rest of that year sleeping in a ditch on the road between Baghdad and Kuwait.
Oh well, if it's any consolation, I had a bad year that year too.
What? You weren't working for the government during the Gulf War?
No. I was in 10th grade.
Oh, right. Yuck.
Right, so we're clear for the most part here, and we just need to be careful of a camera up ahead. Which we can essentially take out using our pistol here. It's not really necessary to take it out, but since the game affords you the possibility of taking it out, I just like to do so. And this is one of the ways to infiltrate it. Now, heard that...
Fisher, I've got a copy of a work order here that the bank filed with their insurance company. It says the dome windows over the lobby are magnetically locked. See if you can find a breaker or junction box up here and power down the locks.
Right.
So, I've heard that the easiest way to infiltrate this entire section is through the front door, but thus far I've never tried it, to be honest. Maybe one day I'll try. I'm planning to do it the next time around in the first person perspective playthrough. We just need to switch this off and
record. Good work, Sam. That shut down the magnetic locks on the windows. Hey, wait a minute. Power spike. The lobby. It looks like a laser grid just came online.
Lasers? Lasers are so...
90s?
I was gonna say 70s. Can you please stop making me feel old?
Got bad news for you, Sam. You are old.
Fisher, here's our advisor. He'll walk you through the steps that'll get you into that vault. Be patient with him.
Oh, he's one of those.
Yes. Right.
Hello? Is this thing on, then?
It's on. I'm here. Have you been briefed?
Whatever. Listen, this is Mason World 88. Each one is unique. You want to get a butcher's up this girl's skirt. First thing you need to do is authorize an opening.
How do I do that?
The bank president and the treasurer will each have an authorization lock in their office. There'll be another one in the security office. You'll need to disable all three.
Okay.
So there are a few ways that you can do this level. You can take the road on the right, you can take the road on the left. Both of them have their own advantages and disadvantages. I prefer taking the road on the left first, but what you do is ultimately up to you, really. There's no right way to be doing these things. But before I solve this part of the puzzle, I just want to go over to the main hall and hack the computer there, because we also need to upload a few emails. Where is it? Right. Plant a series of false emails to make it look like an inside job. So that is what we need to do, one of our opportunity objectives for this run through. And in that regard, let me just go and save you. Yes. So we basically need to hack this, and this is the first game wherein the hacking mechanic comes into play. I just sort of botched the job. It was 19166, and I recall it being okay. I guess it's a different number this time. You basically need to make sure that the numbers on the left match up. 1010, okay. And since we know that, we can just go ahead and choose the correct one.
That's a relief. Our installer seems to be compatible with their local OS.
That's it? Just plug and play?
That's the idea. No fuss. Get all 8 of those forged mails uploaded.
Make the robbery look like an inside job.
Exactly.
From Montego to Iago. If you see Hermano or Tajo tonight, or Tajo, I guess, let them know they need to change the door code as soon as possible. Somehow both security booths on the first floor ended up with the same code. 3624. What are the odds of that? Indeed. Maybe a statistician can answer. Emilio to Iago. I guess Iago is supposed to be the resource manager or something for the bank? Who knows? Personnel manager, perhaps. New medkits. Hey, Iago. The new medkits are in. First class up surplus. Okay, I wonder what that means. If anybody has the runs, tell them there's some pills and stuff in the washroom. The runs, huh? I wonder what the runs are. Anyhow, that takes care of the first email for us. Now, I like to take that path on the left. But you don't necessarily need to take that path. There's a guy who goes to the washroom. That is, for the record, the washroom, by the way. And I'm just gonna save you. There's a camera right here. And you would be wise to deactivate it before proceeding onwards. Onto the next room, I mean. And getting under the door right here, so that people inside the... Well... Inside the place can't see you. Now, the thing is... You see that, if you see that computer up there, you basically need to hack into it and upload an email. The only way that that's possible is if you step into the light. So I'm gonna try something here. Maybe it'll still be visible from this corner. And that's what I'm counting on, at least.
Oh, este uniforme es incómodo.
Es uno de esos nuevos hechos en Estados Unidos.
Ha, qué bien. O sea que no están fabricados por obreros que se matan por un contrato con el ejército de Panamá.
No te equivoques, la calidad del uniforme es ejemplar. No se desgasta en la vida.
¿Y?
Bueno, es 5 grados más caliente. Pesa 5 kilos más.
All right, no we need to essentially gain access again.
No me acaba de parecer un buen diseño.
That's 20 and 192. That's only one option left. And we need to upload the fake email. That's done. There's a camera. Yes. Correct. 2306 to confirm. Tonight's code for the security room is 2306. Right? Gaspar. From Ponda to Gaspar. Talking Dogs. WNN Newsfire to subscriber. June 28, 2007. Talking Dog vows President. President vows today pinned the blue ribbon on Talking Dog. The 4-year-old best of show winner at the Middlemount Dog and Kennel Show in Tennessee. I see, the president has been keeping busy, apparently. Very busy. At any rate. So, one of the important things to remember is that if there are a few doors that are closed, that are open, keep them open. No need to close open doors. I'm just saving the game here in case I need to reload. The next section can be a little tricky at times because sometimes, just sometimes, the guards' movements run out of synchronization. So what happens is...
Looks like more lasers ahead, Sam. This whole place is singing with photons.
There's a guard who seems to be walking around here, no problem.
Maybe he has some kind of beacon. Get close and you can stay in his electronic shadow.
Right, we can either do that or we can just hop up over the side of this counter and just go ahead. Now, maybe we can upload a fake email to this as well. Let's see. Any numbers that show up here? I'm just 68. Definitely not 194, so it's definitely 191, but 10, okay. Upload fake email, right. So we basically need to trail this guy from behind. And the cool thing which just adds so much more smoothness to this game is the fact that even if you're walking behind somebody at full speed, you cannot really bump into them. And I'm just gonna do a wall split jump here, because why not? And it made no noise. And I'm having sort of a little bit of trouble with this section here, because this guy is just a little too fast for me. He just walks off before I have a chance to get behind him. And I did that successfully, surprisingly. Let's just look at Sam Tensup. Just because he's right next to a god, you know? But there are more folk up here. We just need to be a little careful, as all. Let me just go and make a save here, because I don't remember how to do this section. So anytime you hear that sound, it means that a camera is nearby. I sort of missed seeing where the camera is, and I got noticed on it, which is sort of sad. Should not be happening. But well, it did. Now I just need to make sure that this camera is not functional before I move on. We took that camera out, now we're free to move on. Guy entered the place. And I think he just goes in and sits there, like a good little chap. This level does involve a lot of hacking. The door code is 2306, we have already cleaned it from a computer. I don't know when I started seeing that word. Gleaned. That was nice. I think it's the first time that I've actually used that code.
That's a security authorization. Two more to go.
Alright, I do believe we have to upload an email in this as well, if I'm not wrong. But for whatever reason, 68, 40, and 20, it's one on the top.
Good thinking, Fisher. Now even if you're caught on camera, they won't be able to ID you.
That does not mean that cameras are no longer working, they just can't see you as all. And I do believe one of these computers needed to be embedded with a email. I could be wrong though. Like, we needed to upload a fake email to one of these computers. Deactivate fan. Might as well. It's a part of
me. El ventilador otra vez. ¿Cómo es que el aire del despacho del presidente nunca falla?
20.
Nuestro ventilador se rompe todas las noches.
69, 20.
Porque eres el presidente y nosotros solo somos guardias de seguridad.
Right.
Ay, qué desgracia es ser pobre.
That's half of the forged mail, Sam. Four more to go.
Thanks. I've always found it hard to count past three.
No need to be smarmy, Sam.
Buena idea.
Yeah, so that's one of the ways inside of this place. We don't know the key code for this keypad, but we will have to hack it anyway. There's a lot of hacking in this level. For a newly introduced mechanic, they really went sort of overboard with it. And we have only two options right now. It's on 66, so it's supposed to be 67. And somebody's coming over. We better hurry. Time to... Right, I don't know if it's possible to do this right here. I guess we'll have to boot the computer up to upload an email, if at all. Security access, it's a useless computer. Might as well shut it down. And let's go ahead and pick the lock.
Come on.
Let's just hope that nobody walks in while we're doing this. Thankfully though, the bank is completely closed at this point in time. There is a safe behind in here. We do not know the key code. We will get to it soon. I guess we need to upload an email here first. We'll use the computer. Upload an email. Long Dan recalled to China. WNM Newswire. Long Dan, the Chinese ambassador to the US, was recalled today for an emergency meeting in hopes of bringing US and Asian delegates to the bargaining table. Alright, security access. That's number 10 right off the bat there. It's not 193. It's 66. Where is it? 40 apparently. I do not see any number that suits any of it. Like, any combination that suits any of it. This 40 again. I guess we just couldn't see it. Upload a fake email there and just gain access. I guess we will have to hack the safe as well. Whoops. Okay. 20. 66. Not 194. 10. 193 and 10, right. We need to get the gold bar and we can essentially toss it out. We do not really need to keep it for anything.
That's two down. Now just authorize from the treasurer's office.
Right then. So at this point we are free to just toss this wherever we want to. Doesn't really matter where. I'm just gonna pause here for a second, give me a moment guys. So we didn't really need to toss the gold bar or something, but since the entire point of all of this was to make it seem like an intrusion, like a theft, if tossing the gold bar helps sell it, that is what I will do. Now I'm saving the game here because this next section can get a little tricky. That guy just keeps patrolling around the area, and that's all he does. I like how Sam tenses up with whenever there are other people nearby. And he even starts reaching for his knife whenever other people get close. I love all the little details in this game. Really breathe life into it all. Come on, you can climb up. You're a special agent, Sam. There's a guy up there who's been fixing the lock. Although we don't really need to go there. That's another way into the office where we disabled the camera, by the way. We can effectively just crawl in through here. And that's our third access point, right there. This right here is a third access point that we need. I guess that's the temperature then.
Right, that's authorization done. The outer cage to the vault should be opening as we speak.
Great.
Just inside the cage, there's a small vault full of safety boxes. Your mate dropped off some kit for you in one of them.
Alright, I'll let you know when I'm there.
Right, let me just go ahead and use the computer then. I do believe we need to search through the file cabinets for some things.
In sports, pitcher Akira Watanabe arrived in New York yesterday for his first practice with his new team. After a full day of evaluations, head pitching coach Matthew Furland stated that Watanabe was, quote, easily the best baseball pitcher ever.
I see. Watanabe was the best baseball pitcher ever, huh? 67 and 30. Sort of missed those. 30 again. 67. 194, 67. Alright. Upload the fake email. And yeah, as soon as we search the cabinet.
Oh no, Zerkezi. That's exactly what I didn't want to see.
Zerkezi? Is that some kind of dried meat?
He's probably the best computational theorist in the world. He worked with Morgenholt on Project Watson. Word is, he's gone off his nut.
Sounds like bad guy material to me.
A lo mejor era un mono o un oso.
¿Un oso? ¿Estás loco? Ya sé que el conducto es grande, pero los osos son gigantescos. Además, habría de...
You don't really need to do good for this. I'm just waiting for those people outside to get a move on. They won't really come in here, though. And I do believe the hallway is clear right now. The guy who was supposed to be working on the lock is no longer working on it.
Era muy grande para ser una rata.
Like, if you come towards this side first, you'll see the other guy just... hard at work, you know. Let me try sticking up to the wall right here. Yeah, I'm invisible right now. And we need to upload a last fake email, and after that we're done. We have already done this. That's 40 right there. Miss it. My mouse sensitivity is all over the place. 30. And it was 40. Both have 40 in the number. 69 or 66? It's 66, so this one. Because it was not 69, I mean.
Great work, Fisher. One more forged mail and we're covered.
Doing my best.
Okay, so we need to upload multiple forged mails, apparently. And we're cool. We're cool, as far as I remember. Just need to head down into the vault now. I do believe last fake mail was supposed to be uploaded to that computer over there.
Turtle said one of these boxes had some equipment in it.
Chest level, right hand side, number 1024.
1024, got it.
Careful with that gear.
What is all this stuff?
The charges are for the vault, and the other thingamy bob is a telemetric lockpick.
A telemetric lockpick?
Head down to the main vault, we'll walk you through it there.
So this is honestly one of the smoothest levels of the game. I'm just saving it because, well, just for the sake of saving it. And yeah, this is pretty much Panama Canal administration files. And I wonder where we placed the last fake email then. Did I perhaps miss a computer somewhere? I hope not. I wonder if it's that computer in there. If I missed one, I'll scour the entire bank to figure out which one it was before moving on.
Alright, next you need to pop both of these locks at the same time.
That's what the telemetric pick is for.
Exactly. It reads your movements in one lock and mimics them in the other lock, real time.
You guys use some cool toys.
Alright, so we place it on one. And then we go start picking the other.
Right. Now, once you get the feel for each pin, you have to wait a second for the telemetric pick to sync up. Once it beeps, Bob's your uncle, you can pick the pin and move to the next one. Don't try and pick a pin before you're in sync, or you'll have to restart.
I see.
Right. Agree.
I sort of picked the other pin before it beeps there.
Gimme.
My bad. I got impatient. I wonder if bank locks are like this.
Come on.
I don't think they can be picked with standard equipment. I think these are styles, to be honest.
Alright, now place the charges over the main pins. Once they're all in place, well, I'm sure you can figure it out.
So this thing also has a... there are some lasers there that we need to be careful of.
And... open sesame!
Lambert, we're in.
Great work! Sam, get in there and find those hard drives.
The good thing is, since the EMP charge went off, there are no lasers right now, but by the time we get back, we will have to deal with lasers. And I think this is where you upload the last fake email and open the entire thing up. Use the computer.
I have fragments of a message here from someone named Dvorak. Echelon doesn't have a file on him. Wait, that's weird.
What?
The deleted messages. They're 512 encrypted. I haven't seen 512 since Philip Masse.
I killed Masse outside Severomorsk.
I remember. And it's confirmed. So this is someone with access to some seriously classified information.
Zerkezi?
That's a frightening possibility.
So I don't see a point to activating the sprinklers, so I'm just gonna leave things be as is. 191. Come on. It's not 68, it's not 69. It's 20. 66. That should be good enough, I suppose. Upload the fake email.
Great work, Fisher. Now any investigation into the robbery will only point back at the investigators.
So the Panamanian government will end up sending some innocent banker to prison?
Innocent, if you don't count providing arms to revolutionaries.
Oh, right, I forgot. Bankers. Evil.
Good job, Fisher. Now the whole mission will look like a robbery. They'll never know why we were here.
Lambert, now that I'm holding 50 million bucks, I think we need to talk about that raise again.
25 cents an hour and not a penny more.
Deal.
25 cents an hour. That's his raise. But now we need to be a little careful because you see those, if you see those black bars there, they're actually lasers. You can see them right now. And it's simple to deal with them. Just point and disable them. And you're golden. Nothing else that really needs to be done, to be honest. And we head out the same way that we came in.
All right, Fisher. We'll extract you as planned from the same location you were inserted.
Over the wall from the front courtyard?
That's right. Redding will be waiting for you nearby.
On my way.
On my way, indeed. So if you actually take the route on the right first, you'll get to hear this guy grumbling about how he has to constantly fix this door that keeps getting, you know, spoiled for some of the other odd reason. That door over there. And yeah, I think we should be clear. I don't think there is anything else that might pose a problem right now. If you peek inside this room, you'll see that guy in there. But let us just move stealthily through this. We do not want to alert anybody. And we can also probably open this door from the inside. Open door stealth option is primarily intended for noisy doors. Should be good right here. But in case we aren't, might as well just head back up. The entire bank is open and nobody knows who orchestrated the entire thing. Except for the person, you know, who the police will think orchestrated the entire thing because we framed them. Poor banker. Then again, Lambert was right. They have been providing arms to mercenaries, so maybe they're not as innocent. We'd not have to come down all this way. We could have just taken that door over there. And I don't know why I did it this way. Anyway. So, the camera there is still active for the record. This camera right here. As long as it can't see us. I mean, what's the harm, right? Let's just go ahead and deactivate it nonetheless. We need to be a little careful here because the lights are now on and there's sometimes a guy who keeps patrolling this area. So, as a result, I'm gonna quick save as much as possible. This area is not exactly in the darkness. Alright, time to climb up it. The pole, I mean. And take the zipline all the way to the end. What got you so alert, son? Anyway. From here, we just make it to the other end and we're golden. That's it. That's all we need to do, really. As long as you stick to the sides, to the center, nobody will be able to hear you either. And that was that for this mission. I just wish they would have shown him climbing over, you know? Okay, so everything has been completed here. Even the bonus objective that I sort of unlocked for myself, I have come to believe that every mission probably has bonus objectives of some sort or the other. But yeah, we made it look like a robbery, and we figured out that Zerkesi is somehow involved in all of this, and somebody named Dvorak, which is strange because Augustus Dvorak was the person who made the Dvorak keyboard. It's a different way of typing, rather more niche method of typing as compared to our current typing method. That's what we found out from our tour of the bank. We also succeeded in appropriating the funds, not only making it look like a robbery, but also making it more difficult for them to fund terrorists. I would personally count that as a win. Now, let us look at the statistics here. And 100% accuracy, as is to be expected of us. We have not touched a single soul, which is amazing. I like to see zeros on all these rows here. And that was honestly that for this mission, for Mission Bank. The next time we come back, we will be covering Penthouse. And that is from where this series starts to get a little intense. Thus far, all the missions that we have been getting have been cakewalks. Next mission onwards, though, things are going to change, and things are going to start getting challenging. So things won't be as smooth, but they will still be emergent to a great degree. That being said, well, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching the smoothest mission on Earth, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Until next time, when we cover Penthouse to try and figure out who this Zerkesi is, who this Dvorak is, and how is Zerkesi involved in all of this. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.